This is Match Game 74, production number 0159, air date to be announced, VTR 21574, take one. Get ready to match the stars. Steve Allen. Brett Summers. Charles Nelson Reilly. Manny Flagg. Richard Dawson. And Kaye Ballard. As we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 74. And now here's the host of Match Game 74, Gene Rayburn.
For joining us here, one and all, wherever you are. Nice to see all of your bodies. How are your beautiful bodies?
Hello, dear.
Hello, darling.
Gene, I love your salt and pepper suit. It hides your dandruff very well.
It'll do it every time, won't it? Hey, have you heard about Fannie Flagg's invention?
No.
I haven't either. Fannie, would you tell us about your invention?
Yes, I'm very excited.
She's wearing it.
I'm very excited. I have come up with a sure cure for a headache, and it's a little yellow pill, and it's just on the market. You take it with a glass of water and three aspirins.
Do it every time. You haven't heard about her invention either, have I?
I wish I hadn't, quite.
All right, I guess our celebrities are all ready to go, or half ready to go. Let's say hello to our current champion, Valerie Wood, and her challenger, Nancy Jones. Hello, ladies. Valerie is our current champ. She has a total cash amount of $350. She's won one game, and we ran out of time just as we were about to say hello to Nancy. So, Nancy, we say hello to you now.
Hi.
And ask you to tell us a little bit about yourself.
Sure. I'm originally from Chicago. I'm a I'm a housewife, mother of one little girl, and I'm a part-time student, and I'm married to an engineer named Casey Jones.
Casey Jones, the engineer?
Oh, I wonder.
What's his real name?
Casey Jones.
Is that Casey Jones, the engineer there? What kind of engineer is he, Nancy?
He's a mechanical engineer.
A mechanical engineer named Casey Jones. Well, I tell you, you know, living with that name all of your life, I will not say any of the obvious things. Just
but
welcome you.
Ballard will sing a few bars.
Yeah. Okay. No, I'd like to start off by singing a medley of every song that was ever written.
about Casey Jones. Okay. All right, well, we know about Nancy, and we know about her husband, and we'll begin this game, ladies. Good luck to both of you right after we pass along this message to you. Here we are. We're ready to go. Push the button. Reveal two questions. Nancy, the challenger, you make a selection if you would, please.
Well, my little girl's name is Amy, so I'll choose A for Amy.
A for Amy, she says, and this is it. The Sheik was so rich, his underwear was lined with blank. The Sheik. His underwear was lined. The Sheik. Of Araby.
Sing it, baby.
You remember the Sheik of Araby?
Oh, no, no.
Okay. Charles is ready and Brett is ready.
Ready.
So now we'll go to Nancy Jones and ask her. The Sheik was so rich, his underwear was lined with
silk.
Silk. That's a good answer. Listen, if I had that money, I'd line mine with silk, too. What do you say?
I say rag mop.
Come on, play the
rag
game.
The Sheik was so rich that his underwear was lined with oil.
With oil. Okay. He must have been a slippery character, I mean. With 48 wives and all that. I mean, that was created quite a problem. Brett, what do you say?
I don't want to hear any more from
okay.
you. I was going to say rayon, but I thought possibly that was a little too personal. Silver threads.
Silver threads.
Silver threads
among the gold. That's enough.
I'm going to get him if it's the last thing I ever do.
What did you say? Silk is the answer.
I said gold.
Gold. So we got two golds so far. What do you say, dear girl?
I said that it was lined with mink.
Mink.
Very good.
That was the hottest chic in the desert, I'll tell you that. Richard, what do you say?
His underwear was lined with money. No, it was nickel and dime stuff.
Yes.
Seriously, right folks.
We got you over a barrel.
My mother's
before I get
birthday.
My answer, would you have these half sold for me?
Yes, of course.
I'll tell you the truth. I happen to know the sheik, and
yes,
he spends a lot of time in Switzerland, so I thought, like Fannie did, mink.
Mink is the answer. All right, Nancy, mink is the answer that we got most often there. Now let's see how Valerie does with her first round question. Henry was late for his wedding because he got his blank caught in the seatbelt. Henry. It's an amusing thought. Henry was late for his wedding because he got his blank caught in the seatbelt. I'll drink to that. I'll drink to Henry's wedding. I'll dance at his wedding. You'll drink to the seatbelt.
Hardly seems possible with only been at sea 3 days.
That's true. Charles, the stairwell. Now, Valerie, Henry was late for his wedding because he got his blank caught in the seatbelt.
Zipper.
Really? You're applauding that answer, Nancy? You think it's a good answer, Nancy? Would you have said zipper, Nancy?
No.
No. Steve, what did you say?
I couldn't be funny on this one, so I was very realistic. He got his seat caught in the seatbelt.
Got his seat caught in the seatbelt, and he was stuck there, and that's how he's late for the wedding. Brett?
That's about as realistic as Peter Pan and Tinkerbell. What does that mean, got his seat caught in the seatbelt?
You catch what you want, and I'll catch what I want.
I think Zipper's pretty dumb, too. And I'm one of the smarter members of this panel, as we all know.
True.
I said Zipper.
Zipper. Yeah. Got a zipper there. One zipper.
Ta-da!
Charles, are you embarrassed?
Well, no, I'm not embarrassed. I just couldn't put what I wanted to put, so I made a joke, and I said what could be very true is a lovely story. His ex-wife.
Got caught in a seatbelt. Okay.
I mean, think about it a minute before you discard it.
It's discarded. How about you?
I like that.
Pay no attention to you. We're taking her away in a little while there. She'll be all right then.
She's real nice, though. Sometimes.
Yeah. Oh, yes. Splendid.
I said... I get nervous, I either say mother or baby, so I said mother.
Got his mother caught in the seatbelt. Okay, Richard.
Make fun so far.
As this is Steve's first visit,
yeah,
I do want to explain that underneath that granite-like exterior, inside, there's a granite-like interior.
Right. Now would you show us your answer, please?
Says who?
Says me, it's my show.
Oh, in that case, Zipper!
Zipper! Kay Ballard.
Yeah.
Up to you.
It's an awful lot like a zipper, but a fly.
Oh. That's a man.
Right. I'm a fly.
So at the end of round one, it's 3-0 in favor of the current champ, and we'll go to round two right after we go to this message for you.
GSN presents
Gene Rivers!
Someone showed me a single-spaced typewritten list of all the celebrities who've been on Match Game, and it's a formidable list. It really is. Burt Reynolds. You know, we had them all. Everybody came and bowed and paid their respect and kissed my ring.
Stay tuned for more of That 70s Hour on GSN.
Just a ring, yeah.
Here we go. Ladies, ready for round two. Nancy, would you please make a selection?
I'll try A again.
A for Amy, her daughter. That's what she's doing. All right, everybody plays, and she didn't match anyone in the first round. At the party, Lois said, "That's not a wig my husband's wearing. He has a blank on his head." Lois said, "That's not a wig my husband's wearing. He has a blank on his head." Okay, here we go. Now, Nancy, at the party, Lois said, that's not a wig my husband's wearing. He has a blank on his head.
All I can think of is mop.
Mop. Good answer. Sounds like a reasonable response to me. Sounds reasonable to you, Steve?
Yes. I say rag mop again.
You say rag mop again.
I'm sorry to report that I said bird's nest.
Bird's nest.
Yes.
Yeah.
I would look like a wig. Again, I guess.
Okay, Brett?
Well, I couldn't think of anything funny. I couldn't think of a joke, so I just came up with something totally realistic. Lady.
He has a lady on his head. Okay.
I don't know what's come over me tonight.
I know what's come over you.
Annette
Charles.
Well, I'll tell you that Casey Jones's wife is not going to strike out.
Get out.
Did I act strongly?
I love it when you act.
Just like
yes, thank you very much. What do you say, Fannie Flagg?
Well, first of all, I want to say Brett has hurt my feelings, and I named my triplets after her. I said mop.
Mop is a mop. That's two mops. Do you make a three mops?
Okay. Well, I did write the word mop, but then I thought, where would the stick go?
Well, you take a stick, you break the stick off.
Oh, I'm not violent at all.
Really?
No, so I said a cat.
A cat.
Bear with me.
Okay. Nancy, you've got to match Kaye to stay in the game.
But because if you hold it...
No.
The truth is, I've seen so many hats that look like mops, I feel terrible.
Hats. Hats. So, Valerie wins another game. $100. Nancy, it's been a short but very pleasant meeting for us.
It's been lots of fun for me, too. Thank you.
Thank you. We've got a gift for you, together with our thanks for being with us on Match Game 74. Nancy Jones. Well, Valerie, you're up to $450, and now you're going to have a chance at the big money here in the Super Match. Over $5,000 can be yours. You know how it goes, so let's get right to it, shall we?
Okay.
All right. We polled a recent studio audience, and we got their best response to this. Blank Friday. The answer they gave most often is worth $500 to you if you match it. Second, $250. Third, $100. Which celebrities would you like a little help from?
Richard,
what did you say?
Well, you know, the last time I had a good time was on Good Friday.
Good Friday. Okay, that's his answer.
Steve,
what do you say?
Well, we might remember Robinson Crusoe, so I put down Man Friday.
Man Friday, okay. All right.
Fanny.
Fanny Flagg.
I'll say My Gal Friday.
My Gal Friday.
Gal Friday.
Just Gal Friday, huh? Not mine or yours, right? Just, okay. So you got Man Friday, Gal Friday, and Good Friday. You can choose one of those as the answer or think up one of your own. What would you like to do?
Good Friday.
Want to say Good Friday? You think that's it? The audience seems to agree with you. Let's see if you and Richard and the audience are correct here. First, may we see the $100 response. Girl Friday. That was Fanny's answer. That
not
would have matched
close
that.
Enough.
Yeah, no, that would have matched. All right, still looking for Good Friday. Here is the $250 response. Sergeant Joe Friday. Bum-ba-dum-bum, that's right. That's right. That's didn't cross my mind, I must say that. Although it's still popular and it's still on. Last chance for Good Friday. Here we go with the $500 response.
Good
congratulations. All right. Very well done. You've got the $500. I know you are very happy that Richard thought of Good Friday. That means you're now going to be playing for 10 times $500 or $5,000. Got to collect. Remember, you got to match one celebrity head-to-head. Has to be exact. Choose one now, if you please.
Richard.
She chooses you, Richard, because I guess you're a good kisser.
All right,
she wants to kiss you again. That's why she chose you. Okay, now she'll face me. Here's the $5,000 question. Please write your answer to this, if you would. Blank pen. P-E-N. He's finished. Now we need a response from you, Valerie. How do you fill in that blank? Blank pen, P-E-N.
Ballpoint.
Ballpoint pen. Okay, Richard, for $5,000, may we see your answer?
Yeah, you remember, I did give you good Frank. I said fountain pen.
Fountain pen? Ballpoint pen? You think fountain pen is a better answer? That's really sportsmanlike of you to say so. Because I think ballpoint pen. They're both really good answers, and it was a tough question.
They didn't win us anything.
That's right. All right, you're up to $950, and you're going to meet another player in a little bit. But first, we've got to do a little business here, and then we'll start that game. Going to start a brand new game. To do that, we've got to introduce a new player, and we're happy to present Linda Rosenberg.
Hi, Linda.
What have you got in your hand there?
This is from my daughter to wish me luck because she couldn't come on the show tonight, so I have a rabbit's foot.
Your daughter gave you that?
Yes.
How old is she?
Yes. She's only 8 and a half.
And so. She's smart enough to know to give you a rabbit's foot for good luck?
Two of them, I want you to know.
Okay, I see. Can you tell us a little bit more about yourself, where
I'm
you live and all that?
I'm a housewife, and I live here in Los Angeles, and I have a daughter and a son, and practically my whole family is here in the audience. My grandmother, who's a great-grandmother, my mother... And
where are all these people?
They're all sitting right there in the audience. I brought my own cheering section.
Okay. Well, you've got a great clap out there. Good luck to you.
Thank you.
To you, Valerie. And let's begin and ask our challenger to make a selection.
Okay, I'll take A.
A is what she wants, and here we go. Are you ready?
Yeah.
Okay, this is it.
I don't think it was very nice of a kid to pull the legs off that rabbit. Go ahead.
Larry always carries a whip with him because he's a blank. Larry always carries a whip with him because he's a blank. Did you hear that, Linda?
Yes.
Larry always carries a whip with him because he's now think about it for a second while our celebrities finish. Are they finished up there? Not quite. All right. I don't know what's taking so long up here.
Well, it's not taking so long, and I'm sick and tired of you picking on all of us.
All right, they're all set. Now, Linda, we need a response from you. Larry always carries a whip with him because he's a...
Lion tamer.
Lion tamer. That's a natural, logical answer.
Extremely. So is mine. And it's not as good in all other respects, however, as hers. Larry always carries a whip with him because he's a sadist.
A sadist.
Or a sad.
So
and that's the saddest joke I ever heard.
Okay. No, that's a good response, too.
I'll be the judge of that.
No, no. Brett, what did you say?
Do you have a washcloth? I have ink all over my fingers, and it's driving me crazy.
Just show us the answer there now.
I said lion tamer.
Lion tamer's a man. What about it, Charles? This fellow with the whip?
I said sadist again.
All right. So we got two of those and one lion tamer. What about you?
Sickos! She said bosoms.
I'd like to see Steve and Charles after the show. I got confused. I said masochist.
Masochist.
I meant sadist.
Masochist, okay.
That's the receiver.
Yeah.
He could carry it so
masochist,
he could see his
that's
friend.
One who kisses. Well, that's not very good. All right, Richard.
Did she spell that like spaghetti and mussel?
That's right. That's right.
Remember the gentleman who was beaten up by the Marquis de Sade? He said, you certainly know how to hurt a guy. I said, lion tamer.
Lion tamer, you know that? Linda, and what do you say, Kay?
I said lion tamer.
There you go. That's very good. One, two, three. Okay. All right, listen, let's go right to your question, Valerie, and this is it. Everybody plays. Weird Harold has a new high-fidelity record called The Sounds of Elephants Blanking. Weird Harold has a new high-fidelity record called The Sounds of Elephants Blanking. Do it quickly. We're near the end here, folks.
I'm already finished. Hurry up.
Okay. All set, and now let's call on Valerie. Weird Harold has a new high-fidelity record called The Sounds of Elephants.
Mating.
Mating. She says,
The sounds of elephants mating.
Mating?
I told those elephants to cool it.
Yeah, well, they make some...
Flying.
Flying! That's a crazy record. You know. Yeah, well, Brett?
Hooray for the red, white, and blue. Marching, for heaven's sake.
Marching!
With the 4th of...
Charles.
What have I told
elephants
you?
making it only comes in long playing. I got the short version singing.
Singing there. And how about you?
Everybody knows elephants lay eggs. I said trumpeting.
Trumpeting. Okay, clever. Richard.
Clever.
Two trumpets to go.
Two trumpets to go. Mating is their answer.
Mating.
And you get one mating. So at the end of round one, 3-1 in favor of the challenger, and round two will be the next thing that happens, but first this has to happen for you. The time has come, the elephant said, to say goodbye to these two pretty ladies, and we'll look forward to seeing you next time. And we'll just pick up with round two, okay? And we have to say goodbye to you too. I'm sorry.
I'm not leaving.
You're not leaving? Well, will you come back next time? We can put you up overnight, all right?
Terrific.
All right, terrific. You were all splendid.
Thank you
for joining
thank
us.
You. Thank
Gene Rayburn here for Match Game 74. Hope you'll join us next time. Bye.